once again I am repeating here, like when, first thing is when ID S increases, then VGS has to decrease. So if you do like this, then you can make VGS constant. To make VGS constant value, this we have to do. This is the one thing is. So same the way I can say, like the ID, that is drain current, will be decreased. So if you have to decrease, in the sense VGS has to increase actually in this equation, then only you can make the VGS constant. VGS constant. Okay. Now what we can do here, the one thing, like there is a possible of the practical implementation. So what is a possible practical implementation here? The first thing is, let us utilize here one power supply. Let us one power supply. Let's utilize the one power supply. So let us check, take the circuit. Let us take the circuit. Circuit in the sense, let me take the circuit as this circuit. Let me take this circuit. This is a circuit which shows. It is a which bias actually? It is a voltage divider bias. Seeing this, I can say, right? This is the voltage divider bias circuit actually. So voltage divider circuit bias, when you can use, in the sense, if you can able to use the same power supply, the single power supply, then only you can use the voltage divider bias. Instead of the gate resistance, we are having a two gate resistance, that is RG1 and RG2. Here, this point is nothing but VG. So now even this also VDD, this also is VDD. So drain current, then source, because already here what we did here, by fixing the VG is constant. How we can fix the VG? Because with the help of a voltage divider, we can fix this constant, then connecting a one source resistance here. Now in this, we can utilize the one power supply. So here one power supply VDD, that is VDD, and derives VG. We can derive the VG, that is gate voltage VG, through a voltage divider. That is through the voltage divider means that RG1 and RG2. But here the one more thing here, the gate current will be zero, since the gate current will be zero here, because there will not be any current will be enter over there. Then we can say here one more thing, keep, very important thing, keep RD, that is nothing but your drain resistance. RD should be very high, should be very high to obtain high gain. So like if you want to design an amplifier high gain, then what you need to do, you need to keep the drain resistance at high. So how we can keep the drain resistance high, in the sense, here one more thing I can say, this is the circuit, the same circuit here, the one more thing I can call here itself, the circuitry, which is, this is whatever the circuit I shown earlier, that is purely for DC biasing. So now let us show for the both the biasing, like say example, we need to apply for a small signal, example, okay? So here what you need to do, in the sense, to keep small signal, in the sense, you have to connect a coupling capacitor in the gate. This is the coupling capacitor. At the same time, I can say we need to connect a one capacitor in the output terminal also. So now what we did, we applied a AC signal voltage over here. So now what this capacitor will do, the capacitor doesn't allow the AC signal. This I can say it just blocked the capacitance here. This is called as coupling capacitor. See, this is the coupling capacitor. This is the coupling capacitor. Even this also coupling capacitor. What this coupling capacitor will do, it will blocks the DC. It blocks the DC and allow us to couple the V signal, that is the signal voltage, this small signal voltage, to the amplifier input without disturbing the MOSFET DC bias point. Then here, one more thing we can say that a CC1, that is coupling, should be large. It should be large. That's very, very important. It should be large to have very low impedance, because as you know, in the amplifier, the input is impedance is very low, output resistance is infinity. So to have very low impedance, that is R in should be input resistance. R in means that is R signal resistance, I can say. This should be very small. If you want to keep us very small, this, the CCN should be very large. So to make as this, what you should do in the sense, this we have to make a short circuit at the frequency of interest. Now here, if you want to perform something like a DC point and the AC point in the sense, the AC signal analysis, to perform the DC bias point, what you have to do, all the capacitors which are having the coupling capacity, you have to make as an open circuit. Then we can perform the DC analysis. Now, sometimes this is for one power supply. There is a possibility of using the two power supply also. So how we can use the two power supply? So sometimes, say example, let me say example using that is method two, two power supply. Sometimes we can use the two power supply. That is one power supply which is shown here. Two power supply, if I use, how this circuit will be useful now? Let us see. See, this is a circuit which are having two power supply. How you know it's a two power supply? See, this is VDD. We are having minus VSS. See? Two power supply is there. Then the gate resistance, the voltage divider bias, as you know that, that actually what you did here, we made as the short circuited here. See here, it's a short circuit we made here. It is opened here. Here we opened. So this is the point will get us output actually. So drain resistance, source resistance plus minus, the drain current will be zero because of there is no voltage over here. Now, when two power supplies are available, a simpler bias arrangement can be utilized. When you use the RG establishes, that is the gate resistance, that is RG. When the RC establishes the DC current, that is a DC ground at the gate and presents a high input resistance to a signal source that may be connected to the gate through a coupling capacitor. So now this is the one more thing we are having. Now what we'll do, let us see something like a, it is, these are the some practical implementation which I shown over here. These are the practical implementations. So from this we can say there's one more important thing here. It's nothing but when two power supplies are available, it's often the case the somewhat the simpler biases. In this circuit, just the VG, that is nothing but the gate, will be replaced by VSS. That is VG should be replaced by VSS. Resistor RC establishes the ground. RG established connected to ground. The ground and presenting a high input resistance. RIN, I can say. RIN is high to a signal source. At the gate actually. So this is what we have to do. So at the same time, maybe connected to a gate through a coupling capacitor. If you want to make it, then you can use a coupling capacitor here. So now what we'll do, let us do something like the numericals. So let us get the numerical, then we'll get the idea how we can perform this. The question is the numerical question. Let us take the question. Yes. So now, see, this is the problem. Okay. Now here the circuit is like, so it is required to design the circuit. We are going to design the circuit. That is here they given as 5.52C. That the figure is nothing but this one. That is nothing but which one I can say in the sense the voltage divider bias. That circuit only. Okay. So let me take that. This is the circuit which is given. The problem is for this. In the 5.2, this circuit to establish here DC drain current ID is equal to 0.5. Keep it in mind, the ID is equal to 0.5 milliampere. Next, the MOSFET is specified to have VT is equal to 1 volt and a KN dash WL by is equal to 1 milliampere per voltage square. So for simplicity, neglect the channel length modulation effect. That is, assume lambda is equal to 0. So use your power supply, VD is equal to 15 volt. This should be a 15 volt, they said. Okay. Calculate the percentage change in the value of ID obtained when the MOSFET is replaced with the another unit having the same process parameter, same this parameter only, but the threshold voltage is 1.5. But here the threshold voltage is 1 volt. So now we have to find it. When threshold voltage is 1 volt, the ID is 0.5 milliampere. If the threshold voltage is equal to 1.5 millivolt, what will be the ID? Same thing, you have to calculate how much the percentage change in the value of ID. That is what you have to calculate. So to calculate that, what are the parameters we need to calculate? Yes, very important. The RG1 is required, RG2 is required, RD is required, RS is required. Then we have to calculate one by one. Here we have to think one more thing is called as channel length modulation. Channel length modulation. See, the channel length modulation, it's a very simple concept here. Like when you are applying drain current, which in the sense, like say example, the condition when VDS is greater than or equal to VGS minus VT. When VDS goes beyond this value, what will happen at that time? Your VDS, that is the drain voltage, will be increases. That is VD, right? The drain voltage will be increases. Then channel will be pinched off. The channel pinched off. So if the channel is pinched off, there will not be any flow of current from source to drain. So what will happen at that time? This is what I'll show with the diagram if I want to show. Say example, see, this is nothing but this. Okay, N plus, see. This is the gate. This is nothing but drain. This is source. This is source. This is drain. This is gate. See, the channel will be, this will be your depletion region. Okay, this is the depletion region. The channel will be like this. The channel will be pinched off. The channel will be pinched off because of the VD is large. So if the VD is large, the channel is pinched off, what will happen? This will be your channel, normal channel length actually, correct? This will be your normal channel length. But as the VD is increases, what happened? The channel will be pinched off. There will not be any movement of current over there. Then the modified channel will be like this. See, this is what the modified channel. So what I can say, this is completely channel. This channel was, I can say, called as del L, I can say. So simple, I can say is nothing but the total L is nothing but what? This portion, the complete L minus del L. This is nothing but L effective. That is, effective channel length is L minus del L. This effect only is called as channel length modulation effect. So in your expression, which expression? Your drain current equation. So let me choose the drain current equation. As you know earlier, we know that. So I'm not specified the channel length modulation parameter over there. Your expression will become as like this. So your expression will become as like this. See, this is your drain current expression for saturation region. We need to add additionally one more thing in the saturation region only. 1 plus lambda VDS. See, this is the additional thing actually. So keep it in your mind, this is very, very important thing, because it's not provided. See here, this lambda is nothing but which lambda? This lambda is nothing but a channel length or channel length modulation coefficient. Channel length modulation coefficient, the lambda. So normally the unit of lambda is nothing but 1 by volt. Okay. So from this here, that is why they said, what they said, assume lambda is equal to zero. So if this lambda is equal to zero, this term totally will be discarded. So finally I'll get ID is equal to this expression we have to use. Sometimes they may give lambda value. So keep it in your mind, use this expression if they given the lambda value. So now let us start with the numerical. So from this, the given data are ID is equal to 0.5 milliampere. The threshold VT is 1 volt. The Kn dash W by L is 1 milliampere per volt square. Then lambda is 0. Then VDD is 15 volt. Now let us go for the solution. So the solution we need to find out now. Okay, let us find out the solution. So first, what we'll do as a rule of thumb, very important, as same the way I can say, as a rule of thumb, as the rule of thumb, as the rule of thumb, we have to choose the RD, that is, and RS will be 1/3 of VDD. You remember the previously BJT also we studied. Same, the RD and 1/3 VDD, the drop across each RD, that is the transistor VDS and RDS. So simple, I can say, so VDS is equal to 1/3 VDD, the drop will be. So now we can say from this, for VDD is equal to 15 volt. VDD is equal to 15 volt. Now, what is VDS? The VDS is nothing but, I can say, VDS is nothing but, it's a potential across the drain and source. So it is nothing but VD minus VS. Correct? So VD minus S. So now from this, what we'll do, let us choose VD, that is drain voltage. So from this figure, you can see, this is nothing but your VD. Remember, this is VD. This one is nothing but VS. Source voltage, this will be VD. Now what we'll do? Let us find out the, what is VD here? We have to apply the voltage here, VD. That is nothing but VDD. VDS, nothing but VDS will be 1/3. I can say 1/3 in the sense 15 volt, and this is VS. VD will be 10 volt, then VS will be 5 volt. Okay, VD is 10 volt, VS is 5 volt. So now what we'll do? First, let us find RD and RS first. Step number one, find RD and RS. Now apply KVL, very important. So apply KVL at VDD to find RD. So what will you have from this? Just apply the KVL from this here. VDD minus, the expression is like this. VDD, yes, minus IDRD, correct? IDRD minus VD. Because we are applying light is equal to zero. So from this, I can say IDRD is equal to VDD minus VD. Then where RD is equal to VDD minus BD by ID. Now already we know the values, that is 15 minus 10 divided by ID is equal to 0.5 milliampere. Then what will get now RD? RD is equal to 10 kilo ohm we get. This is nothing but RD value. Now we got RD value. Now we have to find out RS. Now let us find RS. To find RS, what you'll do, in bottom you have to apply the KVL. Same the way you have to find out. Now what is this? Not so simple, very simple. The word RS you have to calculate, right? This RS. RS is simple, I can say R is equal to, as per the Ohm's law, RS is equal to V by I. That is VS by ID actually, right? Not IS, it is ID. So VS value already we know, that is nothing but 5. Divided by ID value is 0.5. Then this will be 10 kilo ohm. See, actually we are having 10 kilo ohm. So RS and RD. See, this is RS, right? RS is equal to 10 kilo ohm. Now I got two terms, RD and RS we got. Now what you need to do? We need to find out, that is the required value of VGS can be determined. So let us take the expression. Which expression you have to take? Our ID equation expression we have to take now. Okay. So let us take the ID equation expression, that is ID is equal to 1 by 2 mu n C naught x W by L VGS minus VT the whole square. From this expression, we need to find out the VDS, because first we need to find out the VDS here. So let us take the expression. Take this expression. Okay. Now from this expression, we need to find out, like to find out VGS actually, how we can tell? One more thing is there. This VGS minus VT is equal to something called as VOV. The VOV is nothing but a overdriven voltage, that is called as overdriven voltage. Overdriven voltage. Overdrive voltage, we can say. So VOV is equal to VGS minus VT. Now in the above equation, let us replace 1 by 2 mu n C x W by L, then V O V the whole square. Now what you will do in the sense here, first you have to find it V O V. So ID. So now apply the value. ID value we know, that is nothing but 0.5 into, sorry, not into, is equal to 1 by 2. So already they given mu n C naught x, that is mu n C naught x only is nothing but K n dash. K n dash W by value is 1 they given. So 1 into V naught V square. So from this, I can calculate the V naught V. Right? So V naught V is equal to 1 volt. So when I get V naught V, then from this, it will be very easy for me to calculate the VGS. So V naught V is equal to, formula already we know, from that VGS is equal to VT plus V naught V. Because already we said V naught V, that is overdrive voltage is VGS minus VT. From this apply and calculate the VGS voltage. VGS is equal to VT is 1, then this also is equal to 1. Then I can say VGS is equal to 2 volt. Now the required gate source voltage is 2 volt. To establish VGS is equal to 2 volt at the gate, remember, because it is a voltage divider circuit. I hope you remember, it's a voltage divider circuit, right? So it's a voltage divider circuit. So let me put the figure over here. Okay, yes, see that you put the figure over here. Very important. Now we need to get the VGS is 2 volt. If you want to get the VGS is 2 volt here, right, to establish 2 volt here, then here, remember, if you want to establish at the gate, then we have to select what is the value select for RG1 and RG2 to establish 2 volt. So how we can find out now? To find, let us find RG1 and RG2. Now that is one of the very important thing, RG1 and RG2. Now we have to find out. How we'll find out now? Now it's very simple. Let us choose the VGS expression. So VGS is equal to VG minus VS. From this, VG is equal to VGS plus VS is equal to VGS is 2 volt plus VS is 5 volt. Already we know. So VG is equal to 7 volt. Now very important, from the voltage divider, from voltage divider, we know the concept. Like from voltage divider, what is VG actually? VG is equal to, so one more thing, you remember that one thing we done, like R2 divided by, see, that is RG2 divided by RG1 plus RG2 into VDD. I hope you remember this expression, right? So now this expression only we can rewrite. Like this also we can write VG is equal to VDD divided by RG1 divided by RG2 plus 1. Now, therefore, from this, what I can do, RG1 divided by RG2 is equal to VDD by VG minus 1. I hope you remember, you got it now. Now from this I can say RG1 divided by RG2 is equal to, what is VDD? It's 15. 15 by 7, VG 7 minus 1. Now RG1 divided by RG2 is equal to, simplify that, you will get 8 by 7. So RG1 by RG2 is 8 by 7. Normally, we have to choose the gate resistance will be very high range you have to choose. So what you have to do? So therefore, choose RG1 will be is equal to 8 mega ohm. In terms of mega ohm, then RG2 chooses 7 mega ohm. Now we got RG1 and RG2 value also, we got it now. Now this is also we got. So once we got now, what you have to do? You have to find out. What do we find out now? So all the values we got, right? RG1, RG2, everything we got now. Now very important thing. So you have to find out what is the ID value like will be get if you are having the VT is equal to 0.5. That is what our question they asked. So now it is left to you now. VT is equal to 1.5 volt. Then what will be the ID value? What will be the ID value? So how we can do this? Now, very simple. In the NMOS, the transistor is replaced. The same, the transistor will be replaced with another transistor. The threshold voltage is 1.5. Now the new value of ID. What will be the new value of ID now? Very simple. What you do? Take the ID current equation. Take the ID current equation. See, this is the ID current equation. Already we know.
right? So in this, what you have to do? Apply VT is equal to 1.5.
So ID, we doesn't know the value of ID, right? So ID is equal to 1/2 into, so we know mu 1 CX, that is at the KN, they given. It is 1 into VGS value. Just now we calculated, we doesn't know, right? Keep it in mind, don't substitute previous value. VGS minus VT value we know, that is 1.5 the whole square.
Now what you'll do?
Apply KVL at VG. Apply KVL at VG, the node at VG. So what will you get now? VG minus VGS minus ID RS is equal to 0 will get. So that expression, what you will do in this one now? From this, VG is equal to VGS plus ID RS.
Now, very simple, VG is 7 volt. Already we know from the figure, 7 volt.
We doesn't know VGS plus, we know the value of RS is nothing but 10 ID. Okay.
Now, what you do?
VGS is equal to, from this,
I'll get us
7 minus 10 ID.
Now, what you'll do?
Substitute this VGS, substitute this VGF in which expression? In this expression. Substitute now.
So when you substitute, what will do?
We'll get as ID is equal to 1/2 into 1 into then 7 minus VGS is 10, 7 minus 10 ID, then minus 1.5 the whole square. Now simplify this. We'll get the value of ID. The ID is equal to 0.455 milliampere. See, this is the ID value we'll get. Now you remember that previously when VT is equal to 1 volt, we got ID as 0.5 volt. Now what is the change actually? The change is nothing but del ID, that is change, right? Del ID is equal to, that is for 0.45 is for 1.5 milliamp minus 0.5. So that will be minus 0.045 milliampere. This is the change actually. Now the percentage is asked. Then what is the percentage actually? The percentage will be minus 0.045 divided by 0.5 into 100, so it'll be minus 9% change. And this is the numerical. I hope you understood that how to do this kind of problem. I hope. Yes.